Hi everyone, this is Robert Badawi from Microsoft. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Regression Suite Automation Tool, or RSAT. RSAT helps you automate acceptance testing of your finance and operations apps. You'll learn how to execute your task recordings as automated tests and use Azure DevOps to investigate test runs. Start RSAT and click the settings icon in the top right corner. Configure all required settings. Your test plan and test cases are in Azure DevOps. Enter the URL of your Azure DevOps organization, enter the access token to enable the connection, and then select the project and test plan that you are working with. Click Test Connection to verify. Next, specify the finance and operations environment that you are testing. Enter host names, the email address of the finance and operations admin user. Enter or create a new authentication thumbprint. Enter the default company context for your test cases. Select the working directory where local automation files will reside, then select the web browser of your choice. We recommend Microsoft Edge. Click OK. Click Load to load your Azure DevOps test plan. Select the test suite you want to work with. Select all test cases. On the action bar, click New, Create Test Execution and Parameter Files. This step is needed because these are new recordings. This will convert the recordings into automated tests and create a Microsoft Excel parameter file for each test case. You will use Excel parameter files to change the settings and parameters of a test case. Select the Create Purchase Order test case and click on the Excel icon to open its parameters file. The General tab contains general settings for this test case. It also contains variables that were copied while recording the test case. I'll explain more about this in just a bit. The Message Validation tab allows you to validate the existence of messages that appear during test case execution. I'll skip this now. On the other tabs, you can change the input values to use during test case execution. There will be one tab for every form that the test case touches. On the Purchase Orders Totals page, notice that the recording contains validation steps. Here you are validating the total amount and sales tax calculation of the purchase order. I will now go back to the General tab and copy the Purchase Order ID variable. This is a value that is copied from the user interface during test case execution. I want to use the purchase order ID of the previous test case as an input parameter to the test case post a product receipt. To do this, open the parameters file of the post a product received test case and replace the hard-coded ID with the purchase order variable. This test case will now use the purchase order created by the previous test case. Save and close the Excel file. Before I run my automation, I'm going to change the quantity parameter on the purchase order line. Open the Excel parameter file, go to Purch Table, and change the quantity from 10 to 11. Save and close the Excel file. Now I'm ready to execute. Select all test cases on the grid and click Run. This test suite creates a purchase order and posts a product receipt associated with the purchase order it has created. Watch it execute. I have set it up so that both test cases fail. The first test case failed because changing the quantity on the purchase order line without changing the totals failed the validation. Let's look at the results in Azure DevOps. Go to your Azure DevOps project and select Test Plans, Runs. Double-click on the last run to view details. Select Test Results to view individual test case results. Open Create Purchase Order to investigate the failure. Test logs are detailed and informative. Open the result of the second test case. This test case failed for an unexpected reason, probably because it depends on the previous test case. A screenshot is attached to the test result. It shows the screen at the time of failure. When you are ready to finalize your test suite, select all test cases and upload to Azure DevOps. This will upload test execution files, Excel parameters, and recordings. This way, the test suite can be executed from any RSAT client without generating or editing any automation file. Just load and run. I hope this helped you get started with RSAT. To learn more, go to docs.microsoft.com. Thanks for watching.